Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today's video is going to be probably part one of my Vegas haul video. My husband and I decided, like a month ago, that we were going to make a trip to Vegas. So we went out to Vegas about toward the, what day was it? The August, the 17th, 18th, something like that. Anyway, we ended up staying out there for six days. And when we go out there, my husband likes to play poker, especially downtown. And that's where we usually end up staying, is downtown also, at the Plaza Hotel. And like I said, he likes to play poker and be in poker tournaments. Since most of the time, those poker tournaments can take pretty much all day. Most of them, he would get in like at the 10 o'clock in the morning tournament, and then if he was eliminated out of that one, then he would get in like the 2 o'clock one, so on and so forth. So I had a lot of time to do what I like to do, which is to shop. And I especially like shopping out in Vegas because there's a lot of stores out there that we don't have here in Oklahoma, like Tory Burch, H&M, Chanel Boutiques, Hermes, Gucci, Louis Vuitton, and the list goes on. We just don't have that here in Oklahoma. Neiman Marcus, Nordstrom, Henry Bendel, I'm trying to think, Topshop, just different ones like that. So I spent a lot of time going to a lot of those shops that I don't have access here in Oklahoma, and just kind of, you know, took my time and enjoyed my days just looking at and touching and feeling things that normally I would only get to see online. And I did make some purchases, and so I'm going to start sharing with you those things. And this, the reason why I say it's part one is because I kind of have like a story to go with each purchase. And so that is why it's probably going to take two, maybe even three parts to do. So anyway, so first of all, I'll start off with there's, as you're going from downtown Vegas in, up to the main strip, you can take a street, it's called Main Street. And on Main Street there, in about a 2-block radius, there's a lot of little antique shops and little cutesy shops, which I love to go in. One of them is like a retro, antique retros and everything. It's just so nice. I love anything that's from the 50s era. And of course, everything is a little bit more on the pricey side in there, but I love going in there and looking anyway. And of course, anything that I like, you know, it's not feasible for me to purchase anyway, because I would have to, I don't have any way to get it back home on the plane. But anyway, I liked going in there. And I say all that to say that there was this one little shop there that was called Rockin' Betty, which looks like this right here is their little business card. And it was a shop that specializes in 50s type clothing, but it's new. It's not, you know, from that era exactly. It's just replicas, so to speak. So anyway, I went in there because I had some really cute dresses in the window and stuff. Not that I would purchase any of those, but I wanted to see what they had. So I did make a couple of purchases. And I was also going to tell you, I'm going to get this card back, that they have a Facebook page. Yes, a Facebook page called Rockin' Betty LV. Oh, and they have a website, rockinbetty.com. Let's see if my camera will focus on that. That you can go on and look at and see what they have. The sales clerk also told me that the owner, if you see something, a picture of something, and you can send it to her, and then she could try and find something similar to that or find that item for you. So if that's something that you like to wear, or maybe you have a costume party or something like that to go to, then they would be able to help you out. Super, super, super nice people in there. But anyway, I did purchase a couple of things. First of all, I have been wanting this little box for a long time, and I forget what website sells it, but it seems like they're always sold out. I can't remember, but I see people talking about it here and there on YouTube. But it's just this cute little pink box with a little black bow tie, and it's plastic, and it opens up, and it houses your eyelashes, so that you can store your eyelashes in it in between uses. And it looks like you can put like 1, 2, 3 pair, and then your glue right here. So I did purchase that. It was like $5.99, so it wasn't too bad of a price. So I just thought it was so cute. Even if I don't use it, because I don't wear eyelashes ever, I have a drawer that has some in them, but my leg itches. There for a while, I was wearing them, and I was getting really good and putting them on and getting faster with it, and then I just stopped using them, and now I'm definitely out of practice. But I just thought that was super, super cute. Get a close-up of it. And purchased this at that shop. I also did purchase this little headband with the little polka dots and the cherries. And it is called Hell Bunny. And this was, it's called a hair tie. And this is, or was, $10. So that is going to be really cute. I actually thought that I could use this as kind of like a twilly on one of my handbags to decorate a handbag. But shoot, it would be really cute on. But see, it ties. You tie it. I think it's going to be really cute. Now that my hair's short, I don't know if I would actually wear it as a hair, but see. Anyway, so I did get that. They had a lot of cute ones. They had one that had lemons on it. And they just have so many neat things in that little shop. So, but anyway, so I did get that. And then I will talk a little bit about some of the shows that we went to in Vegas. We have been going to Vegas for, I would say, 20 years now. On a yearly trip, and up until this last trip, we had only been to 3 shows. We had went and seen Mamma Mia. We also had went and seen at one point in time at Excalibur the I forget what it's called, but it's where they do the jousting. And then there was a comedy show. I don't remember what it was called. It's not even in progress anymore or there anymore, that we had went and seen. Anyway, so my husband and I, you know, we decided that he's like, you know, let's check out and see what, you know, some shows. I'm like, okay. So we ended up going to the Paris Casino and went to the 1903 circus, and it was a circus that was geared toward to look like a circus that you would go and see during that era. It was really, really nice. We went, it was like a 7 o'clock showing, and so it was fairly early. We had good seats, and my husband was a little bit disappointed that there wasn't live elephants. The two elephants that were on there, it was a mama and a baby, and they were puppets. And the puppeteers that were working, and it was a big elephant. It was a big elephant. I think there was 3 guys that was working that, just the elephant and the baby was one guy. But they were puppeteers from Ukraine. And there was different people there from the performers from different parts of the country, of the world. And they did a really good job. I mean, there's acrobats and all kinds of neat things. Unfortunately, I was not able to take any pictures in there. They didn't allow any kind of pictures or video recording of any kind, which I can understand, you know, because they were doing, you know, like the tight wire. You know, you wouldn't want to be having flashes going and cause them to fall and get hurt. It was a good show. We enjoyed it. But the one show that I really, really did like, and I'm so glad that we did it, that we went to it. When my husband first mentioned it, that we go to it, I'm like, no, I don't want to go. You know, it's going to be too much money. You know, I just don't want to spend the money, that kind of money, on a show. He's like, look, this lady is not going to be around much longer. So if we want to go see her, we need to go see her. And I am talking about this fabulous lady right here, which is Cher. Yes, we did go to the Cher concert. We had really good seats. Wonderful, wonderful show. If you're ever in Vegas and you get an opportunity to see her, I would recommend it. Sooner than later, because she is 71 years old. Seeing her perform, you would never, ever, ever think or know that she was 71. We googled it to find out how old she was before the show, but she actually did tell us how old she was during the show, which I really appreciated. After the opening act, she took the time to go on stage and visit with the audience and, you know, tell us a little bit about what had been going on in her life in the last few years, you know, a little bit about her and Sonny when they first, you know, started in, when Sonny and Cher was created. And it was a really good show, and she put on a really good show. I really appreciated it. It was good. It was very much well worth the money. And my husband was so kind to buy me the book. I forget what this was called. Oh man, there was a specific name for this program. This was the program. But it has a whole lot of pretty pictures of Cher. And of course on the back it has this one here, which, I mean, come on now. I would like to look like this now, let alone when I was 71 years old. So, but I just really liked all of the pictures that were in here of Cher. They were just really so pretty. Yeah, there's so much glare. And I really appreciated the fact that they put some pictures of like her and Sonny in here also. So they did not just do, you know, Cher by herself, but you know how she got her start and a little bit about some of her movies and about Sonny. And it was good. It was a good show, and I enjoyed the book that I got, and glad that I have that book. Okay, the next place I want to talk about is H&M. I did go into the H&M store at Caesar's Palace, which is a huge store, three stories. And I didn't buy any clothing. H&M is definitely not, for one, for my age group, nor for my body type. So, no clothing. I did look at some of the clothing. They had some clothing that either it was like really, really, really cheap, or it was more on the higher end of what I felt like was worth it for being that type of store. But anyway, it's more for like juniors, young girls, you know. Anyway, but I did find some things that to purchase, and I'm going to show you. One of the products that I got was for my daughter, and I already gave it to her. And it was a little keychain that is an anchor. She really is into nautical. She actually has here two anchors tattooed on her decollete or shoulders right in here. Anyway, so I got her a little anchor keychain that I thought would be really cute for her to hang on her purse as a purse charm. And I didn't realize until I got home and gave it to her that the guy left the little security tag on it. And there's no H&M around here, so I don't know how we're going to get that security tag off of there without ruining the charm or keychain. But I did purchase myself one, and I got this little pink bow right here with the gold hardware on it. And then it has a little gold ribbon right there. And this was around, I think this was $4.99. What's the price on that? It's just a really pretty baby pink color. It looks like it would be the epi leather, I think is what it's called, but it's not real leather. It's just pleather. But anyway, so you did get that. And then I have decided that I have a jean jacket, and I've been noticing a lot of jean jackets being sold in the stores that have patches on them. And so I decided I wanted to look for some patches, because I wanted to put some patches either on that jean jacket or on a pair of distressed jeans that I have. So I picked up several different packages of patches, because every packet I didn't like all of them in that packet. So that's why I got so many. But buy two, get one free is what it was. So I got this little set here because I liked the flamingo here and the anchor. Excuse me, my daughter is going to take the anchor. But I liked the little pink flamingo. So I'm going to put that on either my jacket or my jeans. I haven't decided yet. The other ones I'm not really that crazy about. It's a palm tree, a seashell, and a star. So I might give those to my daughter for her to just to have for a craft project. Then I found this one here, and I liked the roses and the R, because my last name is Rankin, it starts with the R. And I liked the lips on this one, but not the pineapple. So I'm going to incorporate these three also. And these were normally $7.99, so they weren't that expensive anyway, but like I said, it was buy two, get one free. And then the last one I got was this one here, and I liked the rose and the lipstick here. Not so much this lips here, and this patch right here says Plant Lady is the new Cat Lady. Don't really care for that one. And then this other patch says Introvert, which I might put that one on there because I do consider myself to be more of an introvert than extrovert. Definitely do consider myself to be an introvert. So that's what I got from H&M. Okay, the next thing I want to show you is something that my husband picked up while he was playing poker at the Golden Nugget. He had a little bit of a break and was needing some candy, some snacks. So he bought these Bailey's, the original Irish cream chocolates, right there, some little truffles. So, and he ate the majority of them, but he did leave quite a few left for me. And there's still some in here, but they were just little wrapped individual chocolates right here. And they do have the Bailey's liquor filling in them. It wasn't very much because I'm not much of a hard liquor drinker, I guess. And I thought they tasted good. They were good. So we have about four of those left, but he did get those for us. So we have some chocolate. So the next thing I want to talk about are some sunglasses that I purchased from, it's called the NYS Collection in New York. And this was at the Fashion Show Mall, but a lot of these little kiosks, sunglass kiosks, were everywhere, it seemed like, everywhere you went. So I did purchase some sunglasses and some sunglass cases. One pair of my glasses are in my car, so I won't have those to show you, but I was going to get a pair of like Chanel or maybe some Gucci sunglasses, but after looking at those and looking at the prices of them, and I know how I am with sunglasses, I just couldn't justify spending $300, $400, $500, $600, $700, $800 on a pair of sunglasses. There's just no way. So I ended up getting three pair of sunglasses and three sunglass cases for like $70. So anyway, one of the cases that I got was just this little drawstring one here. and it says NYS Collection, and I do believe, not mistaken, yes, they do have a website called nyscollection.com. And so, and then one of the sunglass cases is this one here, and this one was kind of pretty neat in the fact that I can figure out how it does it. Oh yeah, it folds down. It folds down like this and goes this flat. So when you're not wearing your shades, then it's not going to take up a whole lot of room in your bag. And I got this pair here. And let me see if there's a style number on here. Okay, this is the style number 8381. And they are a polarized pair of sunglasses, and they're kind of, to me, very Chanel-esque, I guess, with this little bit of hardware here on the side. And I wanted some black sunglasses because I have some brown that are from Michael Kors, but I wanted some black ones. So this is what those look like. Very glamorous and movie star-ish, I do believe. So I did get those, and the other pair that I have are very similar to this. So, and then she got another case, because I think the cases was like buy one get one free on the cases. So anyway, now this pair she ended up giving to me for some reason. Anyway, and it says the NYS collection there. There. And let me show you what these look like. I just thought these were kind of fun. They're pink or in with a rose gold here on the earpiece. Anyway, I just thought these were really fun. And I don't know, it make everything look pink. When you're wearing them, I don't know how well they're going to be for out in the sun, but I just thought they were kind of fun. And I couldn't make up my mind if I liked them or if I wanted them, so she's like, I will gift those to you. So I'm like, okay, she was so nice. It seemed like, for the most part, everywhere I went shopping, everybody was very, very nice. So there was a few places where I had not so magical moments, but that will probably be in the next video. So anyway, we'll talk about that later. Okay, the next place I'm going to talk about and show you, and this will probably be the last for this video, is from Sephora. I did go to the Sephora at the Fashion Show Mall, and it was so busy in that Sephora. My gosh. I don't know what the deal was, but it was busy in there. So let me show you what I got in there. I did pick up the Kevin Aucoin, the Molten Lip Color in Rose Gold. It's really, really pretty. Really pretty. I wore this a couple times while I was there. And what I did with it was I had a red lip liner that I put all over my lips, and then I put this over the top and just made it really, really pretty. But that's what it looks like there. I just thought this would be really pretty to wear in the fall with the Urban Decay Naked Heat eyeshadow palette. So on its own, for me, it's just a little bit too metallic, but over the red lip liner looked really pretty, and every time I wore it several times while I was there, and I would always get a compliment on my lip color. So then I did pick up the Blotterazzi right there. I specifically got this to carry in my purse to kind of help blot up underneath my eyes if my concealer and powder start kind of getting cakey throughout the day. Then I'm going to use this. I had seen someone had talked about that that's what they used it for, so I'm going to give that a go. And I also purchased this little kit here, And this is the Sunday My Prince Will Come from Benefit. It's the Easy Weekend Makeup Kit. And that's what that looks like there. And the reason why I ended up getting that is I was going to get specifically this blush here. And this is the California blush in the mini. They came out with the mini one, and the mini one is a different color than the full-sized one. And I was just going to get the little mini, but there was a girl working that section there, and she's like, oh, she goes, you can get the mini, or you can get this kit, and it has all this for a little bit more. So I ended up getting it. It has this cute little bag that says Benefit, and a little charm here on the zipper pull. It's really cute. And it says Benefit back here on the back. And then it just unzips. Oh, so I haven't opened this yet. Oh, that opens up really nice too. Look how big that opens. And it has in there Sunday My Prince Will Come, a little booklet that tells you how to use the products that is included in this kit. And in the kit, they're all wrapped up in this really cute tissue paper. Let's see. Okay, here is the little star of the show, the little baby California blush. Like I said, it is a different color than the full-sized California blush, which is supposed to be the same size, but for some reason it ended up being different. But here it has a little mirror in the box, and it has a little brush. These little brushes are good to keep to help to undo your contour. So don't throw those out. Don't think that they're not usable, because they are. But this, I can't get the little plastic off, but this one is a little bit more peachier than the full-size California. The full-size California has more pink in it, or this one has more orange. Oh, there it goes. There goes the thing. So, but there's the color there. So if you have the full size, the big one, I would recommend getting the little one also. There's the swatch of that. So, and also in there was one of these high beam little liquid highlighters, and a mini Bare Real tinted powder from Benefit. Wait, what is this? What is this? They're real. Is that mascara? Oh yeah, okay, that's mascara, little baby mascara. What that says, tinted power. Anyway, and then what is this? I don't know what this is. This is the Gimme Brow. Okay, a little baby Gimme Brow. I guess I should be showing it to you. Oh my goodness, look at how little bitty that little wand is. Isn't that cute? So I had that in there. So, okay, so that is going to be it for this haul. The next haul is going to be starting with the luxury high-end goods. So stay tuned for that, and I'll be talking to you soon.